Hi guys, I'm Exactchaos and welcome to my Opinionated Facts review about Constructor. So Constructor just released on Steam very recently, and it is a remake, not really a remake, a relaunch shall we say, of the 1997 classic Constructor. And to be honest, if you look at the graphics, it is obviously refined, but it is still very much the same game that you saw back in 1997. If you've played it, it is very, very, very familiar. You've got the same characters, the same themes, all of that. Okay. So what is the game? It is a kind of tycoon town builder type game simulation. You're a developer and you develop your town. You can see I'm kind of developing, got some stuff being built over here. And you basically face off against a rival developer. If you look at the minimap over here, you can see this is my section of the town, and you can keep buying up more and more properties. And then also the kind of your rival is busy doing the same thing. Okay, so that's basically the basic principle behind it. Then you also have to manage a hell of a lot of other things. So you have to get tenants into your houses, right? So each one of your houses need to have tenants. You then, those tenants have to produce money, other tenants, police cadets, mob favors, a variety of different things depending on the level of tenant, level of education and so on. This tenant can produce money, workers, level 1 tenants, level 2 tenants, and so on. All of them have separate, so level 2 tenants, level 3 tenants, money and so on, and they all have their own little quirky things, right? This guy has some kind of complaint, so
somebody thinks they're funny.
So
smashing stuff is my game, okay?
Absolutely. Complaining about something happening with his fence, so we'll have a look at that right now. So that's basically the gist of then running your tenants. You have to kind of make sure you have enough tenants, enough mob favors, enough police cadets, enough money, and you have to keep these guys happy when things happen. Yeah, as you can see, yeah, there's an issue with the fence. So they want a new one. Okay, the next thing is you then also have to produce resources. So I've got a timber yard, I've got a cement factory, I've got a brickyard, and so on and so on. And you produce, as well as some gadgets, you produce gadgets too to improve your homes, the homes and the areas, like the subway station and so. Okay, so that's basically then how you keep, you continue to expand, build new stuff, and keep your tenants happy. Then we get to the more underhanded stuff, which is really where the fun starts. So basically, you have to disrupt or even severely cripple the operation of your opponents over here, and you do that through a variety of means, but mainly you do that through what they call undesirables. So over here I only have limited undesirables at the moment. I only have a hippie commune. So you've got a hippie commune, and I just love these little animations and characters in here. And so you can use your hippie to picket the resource site or just disrupt tenants at the opposition, have a street party which also disrupts all their kind of production, squat in an empty house, and then keep a squatter busy so that you can kick him out of if you've got a squatter in one of your houses. But apart from that, there are a ton of other ones. So if I just open up over here and have a look at the undesirables. So we've got the hippie commune, we've got the pawn shop, which I believe as a thief, so there it is walking around, so you can kind of plague your neighbors or plague your opponent's tenants with a thief. You've got a Mr. Fix-It, who's like a handyman but does more damage than good. You've got a tenement block that's got a group of thugs living there, and so on and so on. So you've got tons of this kind of stuff. So it's a bit of a race to kind of sort them out. On this side of the utilities, you've got this gadget factory, a police station. You've got the mob HQs. You can also get a gangster to help you with sorting out some of the various things that happen. So it's quite interesting like that. And this is really the fun part, managing those things. Sending your hippie across to come and picket this this facility over here sending your Mr. Fix-It to come and kind of destroy the piping and flood a house and kind of just cripple the tenant, or not cripple the tenant, but annoy the tenant until they move out. And there you can see this is the pawn shop, so that's where the thief is running around over here to come and steal something over here. You can also try and take over your opponent's houses, like this guy did over here. Once you finish kind of knocking down the fence all the way around, which is a little bit funny, you kind of claim the property. So that's basically it. The game is mainly a one player against AI, numerous opponents, 1 to 4 players on a map. There's also a multiplayer aspect in the game. I haven't actually checked it out. I see some people complain that it's not working, but I haven't actually given it a try. When I just launched the menu, everything seemed in order. Okay, so what is good about this game? This game is... really, there's nothing like it. I've played so many games, and this game is really unique in the sense that, fine, it's a tycoon game, but this whole underhandedness that you've got going on with the undesirables to kind of disrupt the opponent feels like something you would actually see with developers in reality. But there's no other games like it, so I really enjoyed it from that perspective. Further than that, it is extremely challenging. It is very challenging. It might seem simple, but it is really challenging to manage all of this, to manage your tenants, make sure that you develop at a good enough pace, and manage the disruption of your opponent, as well as counter their disruptions into your town area. So that's really, it's a challenge, and I really like it. It's fun, because it's also truly amusing. The kind of characters that you have, really, really amusing. Okay, the tenant complaints just gets a little bit too much. It seems like they're constantly complaining. I know I've only got the single complaint at the moment, but if you play, the tenant complaints is just really, really tough, and it just gets a little bit too much. So I think it's a little bit over the top. When your town gets very big, I mean, my town isn't even very big, right? It's only like 3 blocks big, but when your town gets big like this, or a little bit bigger than this, the micromanagement gets extreme. You have to click on every single thing. If this guy comes around to claim your property, you have to stop everything you're doing, run your guys across, beat him up, and so on. If there's a thief coming, and you just miss a lot of it when you're busy over there. Over there on their side disrupting things over here, you miss a lot of stuff that happens over here. So you're constantly being plagued by a thief you didn't catch, or something else. So the micromanagement is quite bad. Then there's a little bit of a minor issue about it's not always clear how to beat a mission. Here we see a mission. The red team's thief is ripping us off, and we need to sort him out within a certain amount of time. So we need to sort him out. So that's not quite clear how you want to do, but this is fairly simple. So sorting him out means what? Killing him, using your gangster to kill him, or something like that. So this is fairly straightforward as to what to do, but some of these missions are not quite clear how to do it. Then there's a bit of reports about bugs, but I must honestly say I don't know where they've come from. I haven't seen a lot of bugs. I haven't really seen bugs in this game, and I've played it for a fair few hours on this new build, so I'm not sure where all those bug complaints come from. Mine seems to work fairly well. Okay, so the verdict overall, it's got some good, it's got some bad, but mostly it is a very amusing, and for me it's got a very nostalgic, fond childhood memories, because I used to play it as a child. So I think all in all, I would recommend giving it a go. It is unlike anything else out there. Really, I can't even think of anything that's similar to this. But what I would say is maybe wait till it goes on sale, because at the moment it is a little bit pricey for what you get in the end. But all in all, fun, and definitely give it a go once it hits the price range you're interested in. Okay, guys. This has been my Opinionated Facts review about Constructor. I'm Exactchaos. Thank you so much for viewing. Please give me a like if you enjoyed this review, and subscribe for more. Thank you. Bye-bye.